Welcome back to The Shtick. We're in the studio with Dr. George Halasz. Hi, George.
Welcome back, yes.
Yeah, well, I mentioned at the beginning of the show about the event at the Lamm Library, a discussion.
Ah, yes.
With present being yourself, Dr. Vicki Gordon, who's got some title after her name. I know she's an OAM.
Yes, she
and
is.
And she specialises in...
forensic child psychiatry.
Right,
in the children's psychology court. And psychotherapy.
In
yes.
the children's
in
court.
Yes.
And we also had a lady called Dr. Ilana Nayman.
Yes.
And what's her specialty?
She's also a general psychiatrist general. With a specialist in psychotherapy.
Mm.
And the three of us presented at the Lamm Library and had the honour to address the local community on issues that are facing young people and obviously their families. So a very, very important evening, yes.
So Vicki was talking about gender dysphoria.
Yes.
In relation to the ultra-Orthodox. Like, for example, shaking hands is one example, and also the mechitza. Mm-hmm. There are issues with all this stuff, with the gender dysphoria, which we won't go into. That was just one of the, the areas that you people have to deal with.
Well, I just clarify that the shaking hands referred specifically to rabbis who've got an injunction to obviously not shake hands with the opposite gender.
But if they're not sure what the gender
now,
is...
That's the issue. That's what the happens issue. In someone who's transing?
Right.
Say a girl or a woman who's transing into manhood and then they're actually a trans man or a man who trans. Now, what happens to the halacha in terms of shaking hands? So these are, and the mechitza, obviously, is for women on one side, men on the other. Yes. What happens during the phase when they're transitioning?
They sit on the fence.
Well, it's for the rabbis to sort out.
I don't know.
We raised, yes.
I can't take this too seriously. But there are
these
issues.
Are very Absolutely. major issues.
But Dr. Ilana Nayman's issues are really important to discuss.
Well, Ilana covered in an extraordinary way the whole spectrum of what has presented to her clinical practice over the last 20 plus years, and not only the issues, the anxieties, emotional disorders, panic disorders, mood disorders,
drugs
including ice, alcohol, marijuana. But also what was amazing is how she described the changing patterns. That is how things presented 20 years ago are no longer the same now.
No.
And a couple of examples, just for the sake of examples. One is bipolar mood disorder.
Right. No one knew what bipolar was. It was only not even known about.
It was called manic depressive psychosis.
Or schizophrenia.
Totally different disorder.
I know, but that's what people had that impression. That's what they had, no?
Well, either in the emotional depressive disorders or the psychosis schizophrenias. Uh-huh. But the bipolar came along as a mood disorder, totally different subclass.
You've got an audio recording of it.
With permission from all three speakers, so if anyone's interested, the Lamm Library has been given the audio of the three speakers and presumably they can send it out to
I'm
you.
I'm sorry I didn't make it. I was down the peninsula.
Oh, lucky you.
But I was instigated. I didn't see any... I wasn't invited to come. I didn't even see it on any social media, which is really... Lamm social media is not up to it.
Well, you have a chat to them.
I will. I did actually today. But what I did want to end the show with was three different books that I was involved in the last few days. And one is the book by David Slukey about... I went to the book launch, which was launched by John Safran and Arnold Zabel together. It was a co-launch of the book about his father, Charles Slukey, the late and great, who was one of my guests on the show not long before he passed away suddenly, very suddenly. It's a tragic death. The whole community was very upset when he passed away. And that is, in fact, the story of the intergenerational of his grandfather, his father, and him going through from the Holocaust to Carlton and then into the current life of after his father's passing. Very, very interesting story. And the other book I wanted to discuss was Leon Pittman, who just had a book launch doctor, professor, who was on here professor. 3 years, you know Leon, of course, Professor Pitterman, whose son, Josh Pitterman, I must have to mention, is gone to London to play the lead role in Phantom of the Opera.
That's right.
And Josh, you're going to have to be watching this, and I'll be watching you. And I couldn't get him on the show, he's too busy. What a star. And Leon's written a book about 24 short stories about, what's it called? It's called, There's a Lot of It Going Round, which was his experience in the surgery about what sort of stories he gets. It's amazing. You've been involved in writing books and articles and all kinds of things as well. And there were videos of you as well, which I noticed in my research. Yes. So you're a very...
Well, I think the topic that I'm privileged to be able to speak to is such a universal experience. Mm. It's to do with trauma and dissociation, which affects all of us. And being in the profession, our calling is to try and provide repair and healing.
Mm.
And so being in the profession that I'm privileged to be in, and fortunately, with my mother's research partnership, we're hoping to contribute to that understanding, yes.
It's wonderful. Well, it's great that you've got such a wonderful profession that can do things, hopefully. And I won't go into the treatment or the drugs or whether you can prescribe medical cannabis, because that's a whole story in itself. No,
right.
See, he's going, whoa, don't talk about that.
Well, but please do, but I'm not going to be the one responding to it.
Okay, I was testing you. I love testing my guests, it's really good.
Okay.
But the final bit I wanted to talk about was another book, which was by a fellow called David Cukierman, Dr. David Cukierman. His father is Louis, Dr. Louis Cukierman, whose father was Henry Cukierman. And the book is about Henry Cukierman surviving the Holocaust with his two brothers, right? And the book is called Always Stay Together. And it's an amazing book. And to end the show, we're going to a little excerpt, musical ending, because we always end the show with music, of a young lady called Lauren Michelle Cukierman, who had a birthday party at for Diverse the other day, and I filmed it. And she has healed herself because she's had trauma of all sorts in her life, and she has healed herself through music and yoga therapy.
Now, they are, in fact, the cornerstones of the new thinking about trauma that is nonverbal. It's not about talk, but, as you say, music, movement, drama therapy, art therapy, images.
This dancing.
Is the dancing.
I dance.
That is the whole range of...
Yeah, it keeps me sane.
Yep.
So we're going out with Lauren singing a song on her ukulele, and it's about social anxiety.
Right.
So once again, I'd like to thank you.
Thank you very
much. So much, George. It's been great to have you on.
A real pleasure.
And we'll have you back for another whole show.
Pleasure.
Next week, we'll be back with more Shtick, and you never know what's going to be on this show. It's so crazy. We have a mad show. You know why it's mad?
No.
I have people on who are making a difference.
Right.
That's it. Shalom.
Fashionable stuff. Silence is uncomfortable.